Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's market update for Wednesday, April 18th, 2012. At 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast, stock index futures are slightly below fair value, so we're looking for a flat to slightly lower open Wednesday morning at 9:30. Now, the headlines for Tuesday were quite impressive, but I wasn't that impressed at all. Unfortunately, most of the headlines were based off one number, and that's what happened in the Dow 30. As a trader, I never watch the Dow. It's something the media watches and the general public watch, but certainly it's not something traders or professional investors watch. And it had a nice punch through the flypaper channel, and if the Dow 30 was the market, then that would be pretty impressive. But it isn't the market. Looking at the VIX, this is the 60-minute flypaper channel for the VIX. Yesterday, we were looking to see if we could break through the VIX. That would tell us that the bulls had given up control of the VIX. That is not the case. And so this is still negative for the stock market. The S&P 500 was able to trade above the previous high and traded up above the flypaper channel. And that certainly looks bullish. But we ran into resistance, and I think that resistance is going to hold. The NASDAQ 100 moved back into the channel yesterday, stopped on a dime, so nothing bullish there. The S&P Bank Index still attached to the channel, traded up to the previous high, but could not break out. So even with Meredith Whitney's comments yesterday, we couldn't get the banks to break out above the previous high. The SOX index, chip sector, ran back into the channel and stopped. And so that bottom of that open gap is still acting as resistance. No change there. And last up, looking at gold and silver stocks, they moved up to the channel yesterday and quickly reversed. And so no breakout there for the gold and silver sector. Coming into Tuesday, I was short four of my five stocks, so let's see what happened from Tuesday's trading activity. Well, we had a big reversal in Apple, but no change in trend, no change for the CME group, no change for Google. Google had an inside day yesterday. Goldman Sachs reported yesterday morning. It seemed like most people were impressed with the numbers, with the stock closed lower on the day. And Visa had an inside day yesterday, so I don't have any new trades to enter from Tuesday's trading activity. Well, what do you know? The day after I post a report highlighting my downside targets for Apple, Apple stock quickly reverses. And so I guess the question is, do I need to be worried? And the answer is no, not yet. No, there was really no significant change to Apple Computer from Tuesday's trading. Now, the first thing that we were focusing on in the report was the fact this open gap could potentially act as support, and it certainly did yesterday. We did not come down and test the lower end of the open gap, and so that is still a potential area of support, as is this open gap. But when you're not looking down at support, you're looking up at resistance. And so the first line of resistance that we would have been looking at yesterday was Monday's high. And the market ran up to Monday's high, and that was it. Now, this reversal that we had yesterday was also on lower volume. So on Monday, we had nearly 37.5 million shares trade in Apple Computer. And yesterday, it was down nearly a million shares. But that wasn't just Apple. That was the overall market yesterday. Looking at the Qs for the NASDAQ 100, we had nearly 57.5 million shares trade hands on Monday, and that dropped nearly 10 million shares on Tuesday. So not as many buyers in the market yesterday as there were sellers on Monday. So I think what happened on Tuesday is more of an illusion than anything else, and really focused on the Dow 30 stocks. Next up, let's take a look at our pieces of the puzzle, and we've already talked about the indexes. No buy signal for the S&P 500, no sell signal for the VIX, no buy signal for the NASDAQ 100, no sell signal for the VIX for the NASDAQ, no change for the bonds, US dollar moved down a little yesterday, still on a buy signal, no change for the euro, so no changes for any of our pieces of the puzzle on Tuesday. One trend change in the commodity sector on Tuesday. We've got crude oil back on a buy signal as of Tuesday's close. We're trading once again above the 50-day moving average, but have not taken out the downtrend line. I think people get a lot more bullish if we start breaking out above that downtrend line. No change for gasoline, no change for heating oil, no change for natural gas. Looking at the metals, no change for copper, no change for gold, and no change for silver. Still need to close above 31.82 to give us a buy signal on silver on Wednesday. Next up, let's take a look at some index charts. The best performing sector yesterday was coal stocks. The worst performing was anything to do with the VIX. The VIX for the NASDAQ 100 was the worst performing. No trend change here. We're still on a buy signal. So we had a down day, but certainly no trend change for the VIX. Big up day for the Dow, as we mentioned. So the Dow and the related ETFs are back on buy signals. But the majority of the market, S&P 500, NASDAQ 100, Zacks Microcap, Russell 2000, still all on sell signals here. Bank stocks, no change there. No change for the energy sector. No change for gold and silver stocks. No change for semiconductors. So really just a very select few items had buy signals on Tuesday. And certainly if you're short any of those, you need to get out of those positions. But my confidence in new buy signals right now is very, very low. Last up this morning, taking a look at 60-minute charts. The VIX came down to the 200-hour moving average and reversed. And so as long as that holds, we need to be bearish on the stock market. For the VIX on Tuesday, it is currently on an intraday sell signal holding support. If it breaks out above 1862, that's going to be bearish for the stock market. And for the S&P 500, an hourly close below 1381.33 would give us an intraday sell signal on Wednesday. And for the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for a breakdown below 2700. If we start closing back down below 2700, we'd be back on an intraday sell signal on Wednesday. Okay, that's all for this morning's presentation. Tuesday's headlines were quite exciting. I certainly wouldn't want to become bullish based on what happened on Tuesday. I think there might have been some market manipulation on Tuesday. Somebody focusing on a handful of stocks trying to drag the rest of the market with them. And for whatever reason, they tried to do that. And for whatever reason, it failed. Who knows? But I think the market's going to reverse from here and head lower. So any new buy signals coming up based on Tuesday's trading, I would certainly want to reverse any short positions that I had. But I certainly wouldn't be overly excited to take any new buy signals based on Tuesday's trading activity. Okay, folks, have a great day. And I'll talk to you again next on Thursday morning.